telling you to fade it out.
I just did.
Thank you for having me tonight.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you. Something he wants to do. We always tell people, if you really want to get all covered up, just sit next to Jose, because he gets wrapped up in it. And so he's going to come and he's going to get you wrapped up in it for a little bit. So
Good evening. Tonight I'm going to share a story and a song with you. It's based on the shortest verse in the Bible, John chapter 11, verse 5. It's a sentence with just two words. Jesus wept, which is the name of the story I'm about to present. My name is Lazarus. Let me tell you my story. It is a story about a man named Jesus who brought me back from the grave. However, it is much more than that. It is a story of a friendship, a very, very deep friendship. Story of a man. A man? No. He is much more than a man. Oh, yes. Yes, he was and is my friend. But I soon came to see him as my Lord, my Savior, and my God. My story, which many of you are familiar with, happened a long, long time ago. You see, I was very sick, and I was dying. My beloved sisters, Mary and Martha, were at my bedside, crying out, "Lazarus, please, don't leave us. Stay with us, Lazarus." And as I slipped into a dream, I thought I heard them say, "Where is our friend Jesus? Certainly he could heal our brother. Where is he?" As I slipped into the darkness, I cried out, my Lord, help me, help me." Everything became dark. But then everything became light. Everything became beautiful. I was in this place where everything was gold. The air was gold. The buildings were gold. People were in gold. And I saw my friends and my relatives that had passed before me. But what I was most amazed by was I saw the prophets of old. There was Elijah, Moses, and Abraham. And they were sharing stories with me, and we were all laughing, joking, and here I was, Lazarus, with them. And I felt, I heard this weeping. Where is this weeping coming from? I looked around, no one was weeping. Not here. Where is that weeping coming from? And then I knew it was my Lord Jesus. He was weeping for me. My friend was weeping for me. And he needed me. He needed me to come back with him. So next thing I knew, I was back. I was in darkness. Everything was dark. I didn't know where I was at first, but I felt my arms bound and my legs bound. I could barely move. And there was a cloth over my face. This must be my tomb where they laid me to rest. And I felt myself then in my body. My body coming alive again. And I sat up and I heard a voice say, "Roll away the stone." I rose up and I saw through my veil, I saw the figure of Jesus. And I walked towards him. And then I heard him say, "Lazarus, come forth." And I was at the entrance of the tomb. And I walked out. And everyone made exclamations in amazement as they saw me. I still could not see. And I walked hesitantly, clumsily towards the Lord. And then I heard him say, "Take off his grave clothes, let him go." The first thing that I saw was the face of Jesus. And he smiled at me. And I said, my Lord, you came back for me." And he said, "Yes, Lord. Yes, Lazarus. Yes, you have come back to me. Come, Lazarus, walk to me. Walk." And I walked very slowly because my legs were still weak. And my legs began to falter. And he caught me. And he picked me up. And I heard whisperings from the crowd, "See. See how he loves him." And I looked at him and I said, "Jesus, my Lord, this is incredible. You raised me from the dead." My Lord said, "Lazarus, I brought you back to life again because I love you, my friend. And I needed you here with me. I needed you to help me do what I need to do. My time here is at an end. I must do what my Father has called me to do. I must call my sheep home. Lord, oh, whatever you need me to do, I will gladly do." "Oh, Lazarus, you've done so much for me already, my friend. Lord, before you called me, I was in paradise. And I was with Moses, and I was with Elijah, Abraham." "Oh, Lazarus, enough. Tell us about it at your house. We're going to celebrate. Mary, Martha, have dinner ready. Come, my disciples, let's go." "Lord, what is that smell?" "Lazarus, you stink." "Mary, please clean him up before dinner." Well, many who came that day to mourn the passing of Lazarus, we're now celebrating the miracle that had taken place of Lazarus being brought back to life from the dead. And many believed that truly Jesus was the Son of God. But there were some who doubted, and they came up to Jesus and said, "You are not the Messiah. Oh, this is just a sham. This is a show. If you really loved your friend, you would have saved him before he died." And Peter, he had some choice words to say. But Jesus held him back. He said, "No, Peter, no. What will be, what will be. To be sure to tell Caiaphas what you saw here today." Word spread quickly from Bethany, the miracle that happened that day. And the high priest, Caiaphas, Pontius Pilate, ordered the crucifixion of our Lord Jesus. And I heard about how the centurion drove the nails into his hands. And I wept. But my weeping did not last. For I heard that he said, "Forgive them, for they know not what they do." And how he wept for us. And he's still weeping. Yes. Yes, my friends. He weeps for all of us. He weeps because we are hurting and are in pain. We do not allow ourselves to hear his weeping. He weeps for us because we separate ourselves from him and his love, and we are stuck in our tomb, the tomb of the world. He weeps because we are covered in sin and shame and will not come to him. Here we are in our grave clothes, but he loves us anyway in our grave clothes. Yet we will not let him remove them for us. He weeps for us when we do not believe in him. Oh, he has removed the stone already. But we have stones in our eyes sometimes, and we do not see him. He gave his life for us. There's no better friend than that. My friend, he came back for me. And he will come back for you no matter what you have done. But will you come back for him? Can you hear him weeping? Lord Jesus is always there to call you back from the deadness of your life, to live again, to feel again, to dance again, the joyous rhythm of life in him. Give your life to him. Jesus weeps, and he still weeps.